What's a NAB kit? NAB is short for nanoantibody. They selectively bind fluorescent protein. Our NAB kits are named GFP NAB, hence it binds green fluorescent protein, or it'll be amnion green NAB. So the kit will bind amnion green fused proteins. So the idea is you can tag some of your proteins with these fluorescent proteins, and then these kits will help fish them out of solution. So let me show you how this works. In this kit, you got three different things. You have your buffer components, you have your GFP NAB component, you also have all the plastics and the spin columns that come with it. The buffer components contain 10x lysis buffer, 20x binding buffer, 10x wash buffer, 5x solution buffer, and 1x neutralization buffer. Then you have your NAB product, the nanoantibody that has an agarose bead that's adjoined to it. You can also have a magnetic version of that one. And then lastly, you have your spin column and all the little centrifuge tubes that go along with it. Everything is included in the kit except the small centrifuge tubes, which you got, right? All right, so the first thing you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna vortex your NAB mixtures. You gotta vortex this for a couple of seconds so you can resuspend your NAB mixture. And we're done. This is your spin column. What we wanna do is we wanna break off this plastic piece over here so we can begin the procedure. Snap! So now that this is broken off, we wanna put this into a 2mm centrifuge tube, like so. And then we're gonna go ahead and add our NAB mixture. So let's go grab our NAB mixture. We're gonna pipette 25 microliters of this guy into our spin column. This is 20x binding buffer over here. What we wanna do is we wanna dilute this guy into a 1x binding buffer, 20-fold dilution, and I have that here. And we're gonna add 500 microliters of this guy in. Let's pipette out 500. In we go. Okay, now we're gonna wanna cap it. So you wanna cap this tube. So I'm gonna go spin down my NAB mixture slash binding buffer, and I'm gonna counterbalance it with a random tube thingy. That's the same thing. As long as it's about the same mass and the same size, you're good, okay? So let's go spin. We're gonna wanna spin this at 100 Gs for about 5 to 10 seconds, okay? Yeah, okay, that's great. And then we're gonna wanna discard this bottom portion and then put this into a new centrifuge tube. So let's do that. So we have another centrifuge tube that I labeled binding buffer because we're gonna do that process over again. We're gonna wanna discard the old tube and put that in. And then we're gonna wanna spin down again. So we'll do the same thing again with this tube. So now I've spun this down with binding buffer twice. I wanna cap the bottom because it's gonna be time to add my sample. Here's my fluorescent protein sample, and I'm gonna add this in here. So let's do that. Let's add 700 microliters of this into the spin column. There we have it. We're gonna want to put it into a machine that inverts it a bunch of times. Like, you know, do you have one of those guys? And we're gonna wanna do that for like 10 minutes to 2 hours. If it's stable, you could do it at room temperature, but if it's not so stable, you wanna do it at 4°C, don't forget. Now, I know what you're thinking, 10 minutes to 2 hours, that's a lot of time in between. How do you know what's what? Well, you determine experimentally because all proteins are slightly different. So now this has finished incubating, we're gonna wanna remove the bottom and spin this down. So doing that, you wanna keep the contents of the first spin down in case you lose some sample in here. So make sure you keep this tube for the first spin down. Okay? Okay. So we spin this guy down again. And we're good. So this is the first spin down. You wanna keep the contents of this tube just in case you lost some of your sample. Your sample might be slightly colored because you lost some of your sample, it fell through. So that's why you wanna keep the first two. Or if everything's stuck on really well, then your sample would probably be more colorless. All right, now let's go to the wash steps. So now we wanna transfer this to a clean 2mm centrifuge tube. And now we wanna add more binding buffer again, another 500 microliters. Let's go. Bam. And then we're gonna wanna spin that down again. So this next step is a wash step. So we're gonna do the wash buffer on this one, another 500 microliters, wash buffer. And let's spin this guy down another time. I filled up this microcentrifuge tube with 5 microliters of neutralization buffer. And the reason why I'm gonna do this is because I'm gonna neutralize my sample when it's done. So the final step after I elute, it's gonna go into this neutralization buffer. So now we just finished spinning down the sample, and now we wanna cap the bottom and add elution buffer. So now we're adding 50 microliters of elution buffer in here, just 50 microliters. We wanna suspend this guy up and down for 30 seconds. 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, you get the picture, right? All the way up to 30 Mississippis. Or alligators, that works too. So now this is my neutralization buffer tube. I'm gonna remove this cap and put that into my neutralization tube. And sometimes I might have a little sample in the cap and I wanna make sure I pipette this out and put it back in the tube to spin down. So now again, let's go spin this guy down for the final time. So this is the final step. We have the elution buffer in here and we have the neutralization buffer on the bottom, and we're gonna spin it down so that we can elute our sample, which is the NAB plus the GFP complex, into the neutralization buffer. And then you're gonna be done. 30 to 60 seconds at 1,000 Gs. So if you want higher recovery, you wanna repeat the elution step one more time. What that means is you add the elution buffer yet again, you pipe it up and down for 30 seconds, and then you spin down the sample into the neutralization buffer one more time. So now that your sample is eluted, you can do what you want with the sample. You can analyze it by spectrophotometry, fluorometry, whatever you need to do with the sample. And that's how you use the kit. Get you some. What? What?